I've never seen anything funnier than Texas politics. Those are the words of the late, great Lone Star State columnist Molly Ivins, and it's a shame she's not around anymore to aim her particular wit at the current lieutenant governor's race, now spicier than Habanero lip balm.
You have one positive ad in this runoff? I haven't seen it.
We have run ads in the primary, and we have ads starting today.
Did you or did you not?
That's not the point.
It is the point.
The point is that your pattern
of deceitfulness,
your pattern of deceitfulness, your character is continuing through today.
Governor, will you please?
Well, you're running an ad which is completely a lie.
Wow. Now, that is incumbent David Dewhurst over on the left there against a challenger named Dan Patrick. And these guys used to be buddies. Patrick endorsed Dewhurst when he ran for Senate a couple years ago, but then Dewhurst lost to Tea Party favorite Ted Cruz, and then he quickly lost the support of a lot of Texas conservatives, and then he lost a primary to his old friend, Patrick. So what's a guy to do? Unleash the attack ads!
We know Dan Patrick's been caught pocketing employees' federal withholding taxes. Caught not paying his taxes 28 times. Caught hiding assets from his creditors and stiffing them at $800,000.
Whoa, did you see the... That is a really damning photo they dug up. This Dan Patrick looks like a party monster with the shirt and the... Only one hitch. That picture was taken at a fundraiser for disabled children, and Patrick was literally selling the shirt off his back for disabled children. Dewhurst apologized, but the ad kept running, which made for some crackling fodder in their last debate.
He knew the photo was from a charity event.
But Senator, he's addressed that. He apologized multiple times, including right here, too.
But, he ran the ad after he apologized. That's
why,
not a sincere
why did that
apology.
Ad continue running, Senator, after or Governor, after you apologized?
Why didn't you take it down?
Because I called and I apologized for using the photograph, but the facts
why
in
the ad... Why did you take the ad down?
Because I chose to run it.
And as long as he's choosing to run attack ads on his old pal, might as well point out the fact that Dan Patrick is not his real name. Now, he was born Danny Gobe, and once when he was $800,000 in debt years ago, he declared bankruptcy. Now, Dewhurst alleges that Gobe changed his name to avoid his creditors. But it turns out he really changed his name years before the bankruptcy because he was getting into radio and his boss didn't like the name Danny Gobe. But why let that get in the way of another good attack ad idea? Because, you know, any former radio host is bound to have some embarrassing old video floating around. And because Danny Gobe rhymes with let it go.
Aim to cover my past, to cover my bankruptcy. Now the voters know my secrets. They know I had unpaid tax liens. The runoff election's coming soon, and I will try to hide. I want to keep it hid, and heaven knows I'll try. Danny Gobe, Danny Gobe, I can't lie to you anymore. That's my name, Danny Gobe, and I've got lies to answer for. Because Danny don't care what you're going to say. Let my lies rage on. Lying never bothered me anyway.
Now, despite the many factual flaws in that ad, you just know it's going to spawn a whole slew of Frozen-themed attacks in this fall's midterms. Really can't wait to find out what rhymes with "Do you want to build a snowman?" That's all for us tonight. I'm Bill Weir, CNN Special Report with Don Lemon. Starts right now.